Hello, welcome to the lecture on state space analysis. In this lecture, we will be dealing with how to construct a state space model for a given system. We will be taking into electrical system and be finding out the state space model. Then we will be dealing how to convert a transfer function into a state space model. What are the methods to convert the state space model? Welcome to the lecture. Right. Until now, we know something about transfer function. Now, we are going into the state variable approach. As an introduction, I want to say the difference between the state space model and the transfer function approach. Transfer function approach is a conventional approach. Also, it is called classical approach. Because the state space model came recently in the sense 30-40 years back. Control system came before 50-60 years back. Okay, relatively it was quite modern. That's why we say state space model as a modern approach. In transfer function approach, we will just take the transfer function, that is Laplace transform of the output by Laplace transform of the input at zero initial condition. In state variable approach, we will be taking n first order differential equation. Right, first order differential equation. You know what is a first order differential equation? It is like dx by dt, dy by dt. These are all first order. Then transfer function approach is applicable for an LTI system, linear time invariant system, SISO, single input single output, and it is more difficult for MIMO, multiple input multiple output system. But if you take state variable approach, it is applicable for non-linear, time varying, linear time invariant, single input single output, multiple output system. But from academic point of view, even for state variable approach, we will be taking only the linear time invariant system. This non-linear and time varying are purely research area. Okay, so from our subject, for undergraduate point of view, we will be taking an LTI system and single input multiple output and multiple input multiple output for the state variable approach. We are not going to deal anything with non-linear and time varying system. Then we know in transfer function approach, we will be ignoring the initial condition, right? You know what is an initial condition? Okay, if you are using a capacitor may also hold some charge before you give the input itself. Those are the initial condition. If you are holding an inductor, the inductor may already hold some current. That current may be said as an initial current, right? In transfer function approach, we will be ignoring this initial voltage in the capacitor and initial current in the inductor. But in state variable approach, we will be considering the initial condition also. Then transfer function approach does not offer insight into the system, right? It doesn't say controllability of the system or observability of the system. We will be seeing those terms in the next lecture actually. But the state variable approach offers the insight. Okay, what is inside the system, how it is working, those things and all can be seen in the state variable approach. And the important thing is transfer function of any system is unique, but state model is not unique, because for a given system you can have so many state models. Okay, this is very important. It is not unique. Okay, right. Then regarding other terms, like here instead in a control transfer function, we use the input as R of T, output as C of T. R of T is given because of reference input, C of T for controlled output. But in state variable approach, we give the input variable as U1, U2, UN, because we have N number of 1, 2 up to N, N input variables we have. Okay, input, we are not going to use X or C, we are just going to use U for input. Output variables, we are going to use Y1, Y2, YP. So we have P output variables, and we have something called state variables, right? State variables define define the state of the system, right? That is what is inside the system. State variables represented by X1, X2 and N, Xn. These are the state variables. So we have to keep in mind that in state variable approach, throughout this lecture, for input I am going to use U, for output I am going to use Y, for states I am going to use X. Okay, now you've got this block diagram. if I say this is the control system, these are the input variables u1, u2 up to um, output is y1, y2 up to yp, state what is inside the system is x1, x2 and xn, right? So we have m input variables, p output variables, n state variables. Okay, so I can write, I can say input as a vector m cross n, that is m rows one column. Okay, row into column, right? M rows one column. Similarly, output vector as p rows, since you have y1, y2 up to yp, p rows and one column. We have state variables x as n rows and one column. Okay, now we are going to frame two equations. Those equations are called state equations and output equations, right? What is a state? State equation, okay, state equation are nothing but like is a function of, I represent state as a first order differentiation, right? This dot indicates x dot is nothing but dx by dt. Dot indicates the differentiation. Okay, so x dot of t is a function of x of t state, even though x is the state, comma input. These equations is called state equation. This is for time invariant system. For a time variant system, x dot is a function of state. State is called x, u is the input, and a time separately. This is for time variant system. As I said earlier, we are going to take only the time invariant system. We are not going to study anything about time variant system in your undergraduation, right? So we are not worried about this expression. Okay, right. Next, what about the output equation? I said the output is y. Y is a function of state x and input u. Okay, this is a general representation. If we go for the equation, I can say x dot of t. What is x dot of t? It is n cross 1 vector, right? Then what is x of t? That is also n cross 1. You know what is x? X is the state. Right, how many state variables are there? N variables are there. So it is having n rows one column, so n cross one. What is u? Input. How many input variables are there? M input variables are there, so m cross one vector. Okay, so we know in matrix multiplication, if this is n cross one, this should be, and the answer should be n cross one, right? The solution left side of it is n cross one, so a should be n cross one, n cross n. Similarly, b should be n cross m. We know if there is a two matrices R1 C1 R2 C2, if I want to multiply for compatibility should be there, that is column of the first matrix should be equal to the row of the second matrix, then only I can multiply. If I multiply these two matrices, I get the answer in R1 into C2, R1 rows C2 column. Okay, right. Similarly, if you observe here, this is n, this is also n, so I can multiply, the answer is n cross 1. Okay, this is m cross n, so this should be n cross m, then only I can multiply these two. So this is m, here also m is there, so it is compatible, I can multiply. So the answer is n cross 1. So the product of these two is n cross 1, the product of these two is n cross 1. On adding, I will get n cross 1. Okay, these are simple elementary matrix multiplication concepts, right? I hope these things you are familiar. Okay, next, going to the output equation. In output equation, we know output is what vector? We have p variables. So p rows one column. So p cross 1. What is x? N cross 1. What is u? M cross 1. We have seen this already, right? We are assuming it, right? Okay, right, fine. Now what should be the c? C should be equal to p cross n. D should be equal to p cross m. Then only if I multiply, what happens? P cross n, n cross 1. If I multiply, I get result as p cross 1. If I multiply p cross m and m cross 1, if I multiply, I get p cross 1. So if I add p cross 1 plus p cross 1, I get p cross 1. Okay. This equation is the output equation. Now observe closely. State first order differentiation is equal to a into state plus b into input. Similarly, output equation equal to c vector into state plus d vector into input. Okay, right. I have written again the state equations here, right? This A is called system matrix because you see, observe A. What is A? It is relating x dot and x. right? What is x dot? What is inside the system? That is called state variables, right? So x dot and a, this is called system matrix. What is b? B is along with the input, I give the name input matrix. What about c? C is the output matrix. And d is the transmission matrix. Because it relates the output and input, then we say it is a transmission or transfer matrix like that. Okay. Now we are going to, this is the, these two equations are called state space equation. Now if you are going to construct a model, model is nothing but some block diagram. Okay. We will see how we are constructing a model, right? Okay. Let me assume that here it is x dot is there. What is x dot? X dot indicates differentiation of x with respect to t. If I integrate that, what happens? Differentiation is gone. I will get x. I will get x. Okay. So you observe closely x dot. What is x dot is, if you look at this expression, state equation, x dot is equal to a into x of t plus b into u of t. So x dot is equal to, x is there, I multiply with a, I get a into x of t here. U of t is the input. Into b, I get b into u of t. I get x of t, x dot of t. Okay. So x dot of t is equal to x dot of t is equal to these two terms, a into x, thereby I will get x dot of t. Okay, right. The equation I'm drawing in the block diagram, nothing big here, right? Okay, fine. Next, what about y of t? y of t is equal to c into x of t. X is here, x dot is here, multi integrated, I will get x of t. So c into x of t d into u of t, I will get u of t. So this is the model for the construction of this model is called state space model, right? The equation, state equation and output equation together combined to form a model. Okay, right. Now we have to understand what are the state variables, right? State variables I represent by x of t. It is nothing but minimum set of variables that determine the state of the system. That is, knowledge of the state variables at t equal to t naught together with the input u of t at t greater than t naught will help to determine the behavior of the system for any time t greater than t naught. Okay, it's looking maybe a bit complex, right? Just very simple thing, right? What is a state variable? It's nothing but, see, I have something like, I have an inductor. Okay. I am saying the current flowing through the inductor. Okay. Or else, voltage, the current through the inductor is I. Voltage, current through the inductor is IL. Voltage across the inductor is VL. Okay. What is VL? VL is equal to L di by dt. Di by dt. Okay. Right. Now, this I is the state variable. This I di by dt is the state variable. Okay. Here I have ignored the initial condition. Right. Suppose if I need current through the inductor. This IL, okay, current through the inductor is IL is 1 by L integral of IL dt plus I naught. Okay, so integral limit is 0 to t. Okay, now we observe this equation, right, where IL is the state variable, it depends on what the input is, the voltage across the inductor, as well as I naught. This I naught is the state variable. Okay, that is what minimum set of variables that determine the state of the system, such that the knowledge of the system at time t equal to t naught, instead of t equal to 0, I can put t equal to t naught together with the input. What is the input? This is the input u of t. Okay, this is the input. This VL is the input. Okay, by what time? Greater than t naught. So the integration limit is not from 0, it is going to be from t naught to some time. some time, positive time, will help to determine the behavior of the system, will help to determine the IL of the system. This is called state variable. Okay, right? State variable is the minimum set of variable that determine the state of the system. That is knowledge of the state variable at t equal to t naught. So this is the state variable. State variable, that inductor current is the state variable. Okay, together with the input. Input is the inductor voltage. Right? We'll find the output behavior. That is your IL. Okay, right. Then something called state. State is nothing but the value of the state variable at any time, right? So if you put some time, we get something that is called state. Okay, right. Let us move into the first problem. In this problem, they have given a simple RLC circuit. Input is E of t, output is Y of t. Okay. It is given as voltage across the capacitor, EC of t, and a current flowing is I of t. This is given in the question. They are asking find the state space representation or write the state space model. Okay. First thing, how can I select the state variable? The simple rule to select the state variable is just take the memory elements, right? In the circuit, you know, inductor is a memory element, capacitor is a memory element, because inductor can hold the initial current, capacitor can hold the initial voltage. So those two are the memory elements, right? Okay. So inductor current is one state variable. That is what state variables are, I, because current through the inductor is I. What is the current through the capacitor? That is EC. Sorry, voltage across the capacitor is EC. So these two are the state variables I am taking. Okay. So if you have a circuit, if you want to select a state variable, what you have to do? If there is an inductor, take the inductor current. If there is a capacitor, you take the capacitor voltage as the state variable. Right. Next step. If you have two variables, you need to write two equations. Okay. You need to write two equations. Let us write the first equation in the loop. We apply KVL for this loop. It is minus ET plus I into R plus L di by dt plus plus voltage across the capacitor. ECT equal to 0, first equation. Then write the second equation. What is IT? IT is the current through the capacitor. Okay. Current through the capacitor is I equal to C D E by DT. That is the current through the capacitor. I have two equations. But what about the, if you look at this state equation, state variable should be in differentiation form. DX dot or dx by dt format, right? Further, what I should do is I have to write, so state variable is this I, so di by dt is here. State variable is this EC, that is your capacitor voltage, so dec by dt is here. So I have to write it in di by dt dec by dt format. So rewrite the equation 1 in this format, rewrite the equation 2 in this format, right? Now state equation is ready. What is state equation? dEC by dt, di by dt. Okay. So, what are the state variables? EX, EC of t, I of t. This is the input is E of t. Okay. So, this is your X. This is your X dot. This is your, E is your U. This matrix is your A. This matrix is your B. Okay. So I can say this is x1 dot, this is x2 dot, this is x1, this is x2. State variables are represented as x1, x2. Okay, right. Now everything is in matrix format, right? These are quite simple. dEC by dt is equal to 1 by c into it. So it is here. So matrix multiplication, first row into first column, so 0 into EC, there is no term for EC here. So 1 by C into IT, I have this term. There is no term for output, right? Sorry, there is no term related with input, so 0 into ET. So if you multiply this matrix, I get first this expression, equation 2. Now you observe this equation, di by dt. Di by dt is equal to minus 1 by L into EC of t. Matrix multiplication. Second row into first column. Then minus R by L into I of t plus 1 by L into E of t. Okay, we get this equation, right? The equations I am writing in matrix form. There is nothing big in it, right? Very simple thing. Okay, now come to the output. What is the output? Output is y of t. What is output I have given? Output is equal to y of t is equal to e c of t, right? So how to construct an output equation? Output is y of t is equal to c times state variables x of t, right, plus d times input. Okay, so if you come here, what are the state variables? E, c and I. Okay, so I can write it as y of t is equal to first row into first column. I will be getting y of t equal to e c of t, because output is equal to e c of t. Okay, so this is the output equation, this is the state equation. Okay, now we move to the second problem. We'll get much more idea, right? Okay, fine. Now in this problem, first thing, they are asking to write the state space model. How many memory elements are there? C1, L and C2. There are three memory elements. So what are the state variables? Voltage across C1, current through L, voltage across C2. Okay, so voltage across C1 is V1. Voltage across current through L is I3. Voltage across C2 is V2. So these are the state variables, right? So I have three state variables, V1, V2 and I3. Now you have to write the equation in terms of dV1 by dt, dV2 by dt, dI3 by dt. Okay, for that what I do? I am going to write, apply Kirchhoff current law at the first node. Incoming current I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So what is I1? This voltage is V1. So V1 by R1. Okay, that's what I have written here. Objective is to find V1 dot. V1 dot is nothing but dV1 by dt. V2 dot and I3 dot. I3 is dI3 by dt. Dot indicates differentiation in terms of V1, V2 and I3. Keep in mind, right? Differentiation in terms of state variables and input. Okay, that is what the concept is. Differentiation of state variables in terms of state variables and input. Our equation should be like that. So we are moving towards that. Okay. So I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So what is I1? V1 by R1. V1 by R1. What is I2? Current through the capacitor, right? Already we know what is the current through the capacitor is C1 dV1 by dt. I3, I can keep it like that itself, I3 itself, because if you observe this equation, what and all there? If you observe this equation, I have I. I is the input. What is V1? State variable. dV1 by dt, that is a state variable differentiation. I3 is another state variable. Okay, so everything is in terms of state variables only. Okay, so what I did, I replaced I1 and I2, because I1 and I2 are not state variables. Okay, so this equation is okay for me. From this I can write dV1 by dt is equal to, bring all the terms to the left side and bring C1 to the denominator, I will get the equation number 1. Now I would write another equation. Let me take what is the voltage across the inductor, right? Voltage across inductor, one side it is V1, another side is V2. What is the potential difference? V1 minus V2. Current is flowing from left to right. So I am putting V1 minus V2 into L dI3 by dt. dI3 by dt. Look, whether my equation is correct or not. Yes, my equation is correct. How I am saying? This equation is having only the state variables. V1 is a state variable. V2 is a state variable. I3 is another state variable. So what is dI3 by dt? Bring this L to the left side, multiply everything. So V1 by L minus, this is my second expression. Okay, right. Now I need a third equation. Third equation, I3 is equal to I4 plus I5. Look at, apply KCL at the node 2. Okay, this is by applying KCL at node 1. This is, I have written by KCL at node 2. So I3 equal to I4 plus I5. What is I4? I4 is the current through the See, is I4 a state variable? Think like that, right? I4 is not a state variable. But if I can write I4 in terms of capacitor voltage, that will be a, what is capacitor voltage, a state variable. So C into, that's actually, it's not C, it's C2. Okay. I should make it like C2 into, C2 into dV2 by dt. What is I5? I5 have to rewrite because I5 is not a state variable. Okay. So I have to write it into, what is I5? The voltage is V2. So this voltage is also V2. So V2 by R2. Okay. Right. Now we got I3 is equal to, the expression is ready. So what is dV2 by dt? Is equal to, bring align everything properly, you rewrite, you get the third expression. So we have three expression. In what are the expressions? State variable difference, which is V1 dot, V2 dot, I3 dot. Everything is in terms of what? V1, state variables and input. Input is I. Okay. Now you have to just write the matrix. Okay. dV1 by dt. Okay. Right. Now put all the value, equation 1, 2, 3 are substituted. This is the state equation. This is the state equation. Right. And what are the outputs? I forgot to say the outputs, right? They are saying the output as voltage across R2 and current through R2. These are the two outputs. Voltage across R2. That is V2 is one output. Current through the output I5 is another output. Okay. So how can I write those outputs? Right. So current through the current through R2. Current through R2 is equal to I5. I5. What is I5? V2 by R2. Look at the circuit. The voltage is V2. I5 is equal to V2 by R2. Okay. Similarly, Y2 is equal to, what is the voltage across the R2 resistance? That is equal to V2. I have output in terms of V2. Output in terms of V2. State variables, right? So Y1, Y2 is equal to, what are the state variables? V1, V2 and I3. This is not going to change. This is the same for the state equation and output equation. Both are X. Okay. This is your, this is my X dot. This is X dot A. This is X. This is B. This U is the input U. Okay. Similarly, this is the output Y is equal to C times X. C times X. Okay. So X is equal to, X is not going to change, right? So on proper multiplication, Y1 is equal to first row into first column. So Y1 is equal to V2 by R2. I get the first equation. Similarly, Y2 is equal to, Y2 is equal to second row into first column. I get Y2 is equal to V2, right? So this is the output equation. Output equation. Fine. Right. Now we will be seeing how to represent the transfer function, converting a transfer function into a state space model. Let us take, this is the transfer function. I am taking a general transfer function. The numerator is B and the coefficients are A1, S square coefficient is A1, this is A2, this is A3. The thing is, the state space representation in which the forcing function does not have the derivative, right? We know the numerator is the forcing function. Okay. That is, it doesn't have any zeros. It doesn't have no zeros. First model, we have to, we take two models. In first model, we take no zeros. Second model, we take zeros. Okay. Right. So we convert this into a differential equation. So we know transfer function is output is Y, input is U. So bring U here, this term this side, right? Denominator comes to the right side. Okay. So what happens is S cube into Y of S, Y1 into S square, right? We know S cube means a three time differentiation. I'm taking inverse Laplace transform. So S means single time, S square means two times, S cube means three times differentiation, right? So differentiation, I easily, for shorthand, I'm writing as three dots. 2-time differentiation, 2 dots, 1-time differentiation, 1 dot. So, in y of s inverse Laplace transform is y of t, u of s inverse Laplace transform is u of t. Just I am taking, I have done inverse Laplace transform. Inverse Laplace transform I have taken. So, I have got the differential equation, right? Okay. Now, look at the order of the system. The order of the system is 3. The order of the system is 3, right? Third order. So, I need 3 state variables. State variables, I give the name x1, x2 and x3, right? Let I am assuming that let x1 equal to y, x2 equal to y dot, x3 equal to y double dot. These are the assumptions. These 3 are the assumptions I am making. Okay. Okay. Right. So, x1 is equal to y, x2 equal to y dot, x3 equal to y double dot. So, I know in to form the state equation, I need x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot, right? That is the state equation. Okay. So, what is x1 dot? x1 dot is equal to y dot. Okay. x1 dot equal to y dot. What is y dot? x2. I need x2 dot. What is x2 dot? x2 dot is equal to y double dot. Y double dot is equal to x3. Then, I need x3 dot. I need x3 dot. Okay. Single dot, right? x3 dot. If I need x3 dot, what I have to do? I know x3 is equal to y double dot. So, x3 dot is equal to y triple dot. Okay. So, y triple dot means, look at this expression. Take these terms, the terms here. The terms here, take it to the left side. Okay. So, what happens? It becomes like this, right? So, we know y double dot is equal to x3. I got everything. Now, observe this expression closely. x1 dot in terms of x2. State variable. This is a state variable differentiation form. This is a state variable. State variable differentiation form, state variable. State variable in differentiation form, everything in terms of state variable and u is the input. Okay. Now, using these 3 equations, I am ready to form the state equation, right? So, what are the state variable differentiation? x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. Here, what are the state variables? x1, x2 and x3. Input is u. What is the size 3 cross 3? What is this size 3 cross 1? This is also 3 cross 1. Okay. Right. One input is there. So, that is 1 cross 1. Fine. Now, if this is 3 cross 1, this should be 3 cross 1. Then only I can multiply these 2 matrices. Okay. This should be 3. So, this should be also 3. Okay. We should get the answer in 3 cross 1. So, this is 3. Okay. And this should be 1. Fine. Right. Now, you see, what is x1 dot? x1 dot is equal to x2. So, if you multiply 0 into x1 plus 1 into x2, 0 into x3, I get the plus 0 into u, I get the first equation. I get this equation, right? Let me say this is the first equation. Okay, next, you take the second row. 0 into x1 plus 0 into x2 plus 1 into x3 plus 0 into u. I get the second expression. Okay. Right. Now, let me try the last row. Minus a3 into x1 minus a2 into x2 minus a1 into x3 plus u. Plus u. Okay. It should be like not u, it should be like bu. Okay. This should be bu. Bu. Okay. I get the third equation. Fine. Now, what is the output? Initially, look here. Here I have assumed that output y equal to x1. Y equal to x1. So, y equal to x1 means output is output in terms of state variables, right? So, this is the output equation. Output equation. This is the, these are all the state equation. Okay. Remember, it is not unique. This is not the only answer. There are so many ways of solving, of getting the state equation, right? Okay, right. This is the first one, where first model where we don't have, where the poles are zero, no poles. I can put like no zeros. Okay, right. Now look at this problem. If you look at this problem, it is the which format? It is having no zero format. So you compare with that, already we have solved it, right? So this is your A1, 6 is your A1, this is your A2, this is your A3. It should be like minus A3, minus A2, minus A1 and B into U. So 1 into these terms, right? Okay. If the question is given, you have to proceed in this format, right? You have to take the differential equation, then substitute, then proceed. For generally, I have solved for one problem, right? Then suppose if there is number, right, 2 by s cube plus 7 s square, like that, you have to substitute the values of a1, a2 and a3. Okay, based on the previous derivation, we can fill those values. That's it. We move to the next problem. In this model, look at, we have this zeros, right? We have some zeros. That is what we say, having derivative terms. Okay, this model is quite a bit difficult model to derive and to solve also, but I will make things easier for you. Okay, try to write, bring the denominator to the right side, bring this denominator to the left side. S cube, so 3 dots, s square, so 2 times differentiation, s 1 time differentiation. So Laplace transform of y of s is y, simple y. So u of s 3 times 3 triple dot, like that. Okay, just I have taken inverse Laplace transform. Okay, it's a what order? Look at the denominator power. It's a third order. S cube is the third order. So we will be using three state variables. They are x1, x2 and x3. Right. Here we are assuming that let x1 equal to y minus beta time beta naught times u. x2 is equal to x1 dot minus beta 1 times u. These are the assumptions we are making. Okay, right. But I know to form the state variable, state equation, I need x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot. Okay, so what is x1 dot? x1 dot is equal to x2 plus beta 1 u. Okay, you can just rewrite, look at this expression, right? What is x1 dot? x1 dot is equal to, bring beta 1 u to the right side, I get x2 plus beta 1 u. What is x2 dot? x3 plus beta 2 u. What is x3 dot? It is minus a3 x1 minus a2 x2 minus a1 x3 plus beta 3 u. Now, we will see what is beta. This is the relation for beta, right? I will help you how to remember things easily. Okay, it may be looking complex now, you will understand very easily now. So, first beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. We need this beta value. So, fill, it's equal to beta and beta naught equal to b naught, beta 1 equal to b1, beta 2 equal to b2, beta 3 equal to b3. Fill these things first. Okay, next. Once you found out beta naught, you have to subtract with the second term. Beta 1 is equal to b1 minus beta naught. Next, beta 1, beta 2 will be you coming in the beta 2. Similarly, beta 2, beta 1, beta naught will be coming in beta 3. Beta naught, beta 1, beta 2. Now you fill a1. A2, A1, A3, A2, A1. Okay, right. So this you have to remember, right? You have to remember. Okay. Now, I have written the expressions, right? So this is what is x1 dot, what is x2 dot, what is x3 dot. What is x1 dot is x2 plus beta 1 u. So try to write in matrix form. What is x1 dot is equal to first row into first column, if you multiply 0 into x1 plus 1 into x2 plus 0 into x3. Okay, so I have only x2 is there, plus beta 1 into u. Second, for finding out the x2 dot, second row into first column, 0 into x1 plus 0 into x2 plus x3, 1 into x3 plus beta 2 into u. So finding out the third one, third state variable, differential state, difference, first order differentiation of the state variable, that is x3 dot minus a3 into x1 minus a2 into x2 minus a1 into x3 plus beta 3 into u. Okay, you obtain this. This is the state equation. Then regarding the output equation, it is the standard form 100. Okay, you observe here what is output. Initially we assume that x1 is equal to y minus beta naught u. I need y, so bring beta naught y to the left side. I will get a y equal to x1 plus beta naught u. Now we know what is a3, a2 and a1. What is a3? Okay, these are the variables a3, a2 and a1, and we have to just find what is beta naught, beta 1 and beta 2 and beta 3. I will help you to write how easily. Okay, let us say beta naught, what are the variables required? Beta naught, beta 1, write it here clearly, beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. What is beta naught? Equal to b naught. Beta 1 equal to b1, beta 2 equal to b2, beta 3 equal to b3. Initially you start it like this. Okay next, beta 1 means we should find beta naught. Beta 2 means already we should find beta naught and minus beta 1. Beta 3 means already we should find beta naught, beta 1 and beta 2. This already we find. Now you just fill the a values. Okay, like it should be like here it is, like some other color, a2, sorry, here it is a1, beta 1 means a1, beta 2 means a2 a1, because we don't have a naught term, remember, right? Here a3 a2 a1. Okay, we know what is b naught, b1, b2, b3, a1, a2, a3, because a naught is not there. From the given transfer function itself we can find it out, right? We know what is b naught. This is my b naught, this is my b naught, b1, b2, b3. A naught is not there, a1, a2 and a3. Just you have to construct the beta naught, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3 values, then you have to fit it in the standard equation. We will get the solution. Okay, right. Now you take a problem. If you observe the problem, it is a third order equation, so we need three state variables, x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot, and in the last row we will be filling like this is my a3, a2, a1. Okay, this is my a3, a2, a1, right? So it should be like same order, the numerator denominator should be of same order, right? So here a3, so what is missing is s. You can see here, compare the standard one, right? This is a standard expression. Okay, what is missing? S cube is missing. So b0 is 0, so b1 is 1, b2 is 3 and b3 is 4. So I can write b3. This is my b3, b2, b1. B0 is 0. Okay, so I can compare, use this table. I can fill the last row. I can fill the last row. I can fill this also. Now only thing I have to find out, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, beta naught also. Okay, right. Okay, already I have explained what is beta naught, b naught, beta 1, b1 minus beta 2, beta 3. Substitute this sum, b naught is not there, right? Because s cube term is not there. So beta naught is 3. Sorry, beta naught is equal to 0. Okay, because this term sum is not having s cube term. For this problem, this sort of problems, you should have the same orders, right? Numerator denominator should be in the same powers. If some term is not there, we'll put the coefficient as 0. So beta naught equal to b naught. Okay, I got these all values. Now you have to substitute in beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. We get the state space model. Okay, right. Okay, then another model, that's your cascade decomposition, right? Suppose a transfer function, you can split it into this format, right? You can split it into this format like zeros and poles. Zeros divided by pole, zero divided by pole means simply I can construct like minus p1, minus p2, minus p3. See how many equations, how many models are there separately? Three models. So x1 dot, x2 dot, x3 dot. In the diagonal elements, I will place the poles. Above those poles, 0 minus pole, z3 minus p3, z3 minus p3. Then here I will keep this constant. The constant which is available here, k will be coming here into ut. So this is my state equation. This is my state equation. Then to find the output equation, what I do? Z1 minus p1, z2 minus p2, z3 minus p3 separately into state variables x1, x2, x3 plus k into ut. You take a problem. Okay, I didn't derive anything. For derivation and all, you can refer Ananda Kumar book, right? Ananda Kumar control system. That book is clearly explained these things, right? Okay, fine. Now, suppose a transfer function is given like this. What I am doing is I can split into s cube plus 5s square plus 6s can be written like this. S cube plus 6s square plus 9s plus 4 can be written like this, right? Now I can group it like s by s plus 1, s plus 2 by s plus 1, s plus 3 by s plus 4, right? So what are the poles? This is my p1, p2, p3. So minus p1, minus p2, minus p3. Then here 2 minus 1 is coming here. 3 minus 4 is coming here. 3 minus 4 is coming here, right? Z3 minus p3, z3 minus p3. This is my minus p3. Okay, right. Here it is k. What is k in this problem? 5 into u. Here it is z1 minus p1, z2 minus p2, z3 minus p3 plus k into input. Okay, if you have doubts, you can refer this slide, right? This will help you how to fill those values. This form of connection is called cascade connection. If something is in multiplication, we say they are cascade. This is how we can realize a state model using cascade connection. Okay, this is not unique, right? There are so many ways. Okay, this is one model. Okay, next we move into parallel form. This is also called as diagonal canonical form. In parallel form, I have constant divided by the poles, constant divided by the simple poles, constant divided by the simple poles plus some constant k. In this, what I do, diagonally I will put the poles into, so how many different functions are there, like three terms are there and some constant is there. So what I do is I will take three state variables. It's a third order, right? It's a third order. If you multiply everything, three poles are the third order. So I have three state variables, x1, x2 and x3, and a differentiation form x1 dot, x2 dot and x3 dot. So I will fill the diagonal elements. Then I will put 1, 1, 1 u of t. Here I will put the numerator terms, right? Here k1, k2, k3, then k into u. If you take an example, you will see that, right? So this is the thing given. S cube format is given. You can solve any method, right? If it is given in, we can go for the which method? When they are same, I think we can go for the second one, that zeros method. You can use this method also. Okay, you can use this method. State space model, in which the input is having force derivative terms, numerator is having some terms, mean derivative, it is having zeros, means you can this method also, beta naught, beta 1, this method also you can use to solve. Or else you can, like cascade form also you can solve. Now we are going to see another method, that is your parallel method. Okay, in parallel method, what you do, we first divide. Since they are equal powers, we divide once. So I can write this term, convert this term into 1 plus this format. Right, now take partial fraction, very important. Take partial fraction, it likes if I factorize this, what I will be getting, I can write this as s plus 1 into s plus 2 into s plus 3. Okay, so I can write 1 plus a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 2 plus c by s plus 3. I got a as 1, b as minus 4, c as 4. Okay, so that is I have written 1 plus a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 2 plus c by s plus 3. find out A, B, C using partial fraction. I got those values, right? Okay. Now, you have to observe what is P1. P1 is 1, P2 is 2, P3 is 3. What is K1? K1 is 1, K2 is minus 4, K3 is 4. We just substitute in the standard expression we have seen in the previous slide. Okay, this is standard expression. K1, K2, K3, other things are all there, right? Okay. So you just fill those values. Okay, fill the diagonal elements by P1, P2, P3, minus P1, P2, P3, here 1, 1, 1. Here, Y2 is equal to K1, K2, K3 into X1, X2, X3 plus 1 into K into U. Here the K is 1. Okay, that's it. Okay, now this is some, suppose if the poles are repeating, what I should do? Look, what is the order of the system? Yes, cube is 3, cube is there, square is there, one pole is there. So order is 6, so 6 variables I am taking. What is the pole 1? P1 is 2, but it is repeating 3 times. Here pole 2 is 1. Here the pole is 4, which is one time it is coming. Here this is coming 2 times, this is coming 3 times. So I fill the diagonal elements, minus 2, minus, minus 2 thrice. In Jordan block, I will be making this 1 and 1 here. This block. And this block. Okay. These are called Jordan block. You see, right? Then for a single last is coming in here, right? So this is for minus P1. This is for minus P2 diagonal elements. This is minus P3. Okay. Here, before and all, we used to put 1, 1, 1. So, since 3 poles are repeating, 0, 0, here we put 1. 2 poles means 0, 1. So, it is as usual, it's 1. This is another way. But these are, there are so many methods, right? There are any method you can opt. This is by parallel decomposition. Parallel decomposition. Okay, this is a brief idea regarding the state space representation. Okay, in the next lecture, we will be seeing about state transition matrix, how to convert we will go the reverse, right? If A, B, C, D are given, how to find the transfer function, then we will see controllability and observability. We will finish the state space analysis in the next lecture. Okay, it's already 52 minutes lecture, right? I hope you understood, right? Okay. Please comment in the comment section. If you have any doubts, please subscribe the channel Fundamental Learner. I hope you find this lecture quite useful. Thanks for listening. See you again in the next lecture. Thank you.